this is it. You know, it's always a crunch time. Tonight, cut some weight. Tomorrow, weigh in. Friday, fight. The Friday fights are always, it's always a weird feeling because we're used to fighting on Saturdays, but I like the Friday fights. We get it done early, get in there, do the work, and then we celebrate Saturday.
Hey, how you doing? You good? Hey, how you doing?
Good to see you.
Good to see you too.
Hey, how are you?
That's all good. It's okay. I'm there with you.
Watch your step.
What's up, guys? They didn't tell me it was just gonna be a one-person deal. See, y'all came down ready for stare downs and everything. They did me like that.
We could throw somebody up there if you want to just stare.
I mean, if you want to.
I mean, you got the poster if you want to do it.
I mean, that does he does look ready.
Where do you stand physically right now? I mean, I know that, you know, you've cut weight your whole life, but I know it's not a fun one for you. Where do you stand right now?
It's never a fun one, but I feel amazing actually right now. I got to get it's uncharacteristic. Usually that day, that last day of weight cut, I usually wait till the last night and just get it off. I don't do anything all day, but this morning I had the urge. I got up, had breakfast, went to the PI, got in a good hard workout. I feel amazing, got something to eat, so feeling good. Fans are fickle. It's basically, you know, they love you when they want to love you, they hate you when they want to hate you. It doesn't matter. You can be winning, but at some point they're gonna get tired of you winning. So they're gonna be like, oh man, I wish someone would beat him, someone would beat him. Or you could be losing and then they start cheering for you, getting behind you, rooting for you. So it really doesn't matter. My job is to go out there and win and reap the fruits of my labor.
Hey, how are you? Good. And I told her I could. Hey, good to see you, buddy. How are you?
So,
have a seat, bro.
So like always, this is just for broadcast.
And so for me, luck in my mind, people say you're lucky, is I attested to when preparation meets opportunity. That's luck for me. And so I'm like, okay, I'm not gonna not be prepared here.
Yeah.
And then there's an opportunity. This guy just missed weight. And we know he's a big boy,
right?
And he's having to cut all this weight again. So if he doesn't make weight, then they're like, shit, wish we would've had somebody here. And I'd be sitting at home like, God damn it, I should've been there. So I wasn't gonna let that opportunity slip by. So I was fully prepared to be the world champion that day.
Actually, yeah. I got over in December.
Steve is a cool guy. It's crazy because he lost full time, you know?
I remember the last time that what opened my eyes when I was in college. My freshman year, there was this guy named Keaton that was like, he was a big guy, he was on the wrestling team too, but he played football. And he always like picking on everybody, some of the guys is because he could wrestle too, and he was big. Our kids be acting up. And one night, like, it was in the hallway, because all the wrestlers were on the same floor in the dorms, everyone. And he kept trying to pick on guys, talking mad shit, and I didn't want to fight because I was afraid. I was like, damn, like, when in college, I'm gonna get kicked out, I'm afraid, I don't want to do that. So he kept talking and pushing me, calling you a bitch, trying to test you like a man, and I'm like, I'm scared, really scared, because he's big, you know, he's a big dude, and he can wrestle too. I'm like, damn, you know, I'm scared, I don't want to fight, calling you a pussy and this. Now the rest of the wrestlers are all starting to kind of, you know, mumble and say stuff. It just got me to that point again. I got so mad, I black out. I was like, fuck it, let's go. Next thing you know, it was a mob, like the whole dorm, like I think four stories, everybody was outside. Mob waiting, like, you know, to see this fight. It was probably 1 a.m. I was like, fuck it. I was already blacked out. I walked downstairs. I was like the last one out of the dorms. Literally, everybody in the dorms out. I was the last one out. I walked out. Within 5 seconds, he turned around. What? He ran upon me and threw a jab. All I did was just, I don't even remember. I just remember doing this. Straight right. Boom. Crumbled. I just turned. As soon as I threw it, boom. Crumbled. Turned. Walked off. Went back in the dorms. Went to my room. Shut the door.
Yo. It's a pride, you know.
I remember going to my room.
A lot of Africans born in Africa, they have pride. They can't go to sleep losing. And if they lose, they're going to come back for you. And they lose again, they will come back for you. And they lose again and come back for you. And 9 out of 10, they're going to get you one time and they're going to be happy. And I remember some of these fight kids, I fought this kid for, I think, for 11 years. We fought almost every weekend or every other weekend. We fought at least 20, 30 times. We fought a lot of times. I don't remember how many times. But he win one, I win one. He win one, I win one. And it's gonna keep going, it's nonstop. And people don't try to break it, they let you fight. And sometimes it's not really being bad or good, just sometimes just you have to do that. Bucka, 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 bucka. You know the deal. Swayzo. Beast by Supremo for all of my people, Negroes and Latinos, and even the gringos. Yo, check it, one for Charlie Hustle, two for Steady Rock, three for the fourth coming live, future shot. It's five dimensions, six senses, seven firmaments of heaven to hell, 8 million stories to tell, nine planets faithfully keep in orbit with the probable tenth. The universe expands length, the body of my text possess extra strength, power lifted powerless, up out of this towering inferno, my ink so hot it burned through the journal. I'm blacker than midnight on bro, where you myrtle, hip hop past all your tall social hurdles, like the nationwide projects, prison industry complex, working class poor, better keep your alarm set. Streets too loud to ever hear freedom ring. Say it back in with your sleep. It's dangerous to dream. For cha-ching cats, get they chip-back. You dead now. Killing fields need blood to graze the cash cow. Some numbers game, but shit don't add up somehow. Like I got 16 to 32 bars to rock it, but only 15% of profits. Ever seen my pockets like.
I didn't choose to be one of the first Nigerians ever in the sport of mixed martial arts making waves like this. I didn't choose to. I was put in that place. Just like Francis Ngannou didn't choose to be the biggest Cameroonian mixed martial artist star, or Israel Adesanya coming in now, or Sadiq Youssef. We didn't choose, or Razak Al-Hassan, the only Ghanaian fighter in the UFC. We didn't choose these paths. They chose us. We were created and we were put on the planet to be those trailblazers.
I've been thinking about it lately. Ain't nobody pay me for all the shit that I done. It's just ain't nobody pay me. I'ma get crazy. Everybody get a little something. Word is born. I was born on the first day of summer. Started talking about the wintertime. Woken by the spring, motherfucker. I'ma get it, mom. Brought up like a king. I don't fuck her. I don't get in line. No right link. No support, dude. I don't wanna argue. Know what time it is, cocked a 9 and 10. Out of town, let's get flabbergasted in the parking lot.
You're catching somebody at the very end of camp that done all the training, right? I mean, 6 weeks, 8 weeks, whatever it is, battling in their head, how's the fight gonna go? How's it all gonna happen? All that mental stress. The mental stress really is sometimes worse than the physical stress because you're carrying it around. If I tell you, hey, guess what, man? In 6 weeks, you're gonna fight this guy and everybody you know is gonna be there watching you, that's stressful. So it's reaching its pinnacle at that final week. And so to add the weight cut on top of that, to make yourself as physically drained as possible, and you're at the peak of the mental stress, sometimes that can bubble over with some people. So we wanna control the controllables, right? We wanna mitigate as many things as we can. So that's why we control the weight. That's why we have discipline and get the weight down early in camp. And make sure that week isn't really so hard. Like you see Macy over there, she's happy, happy-go-lucky, you know, because she's done the work, she's put the work in, she's been on top of her game with her nutrition, and that's the only way to do it. So it's hard for some people, but I would say that's lack of preparation.
You know, inevitably people just don't like to suffer. I mean, that's one thing that you become pretty keen on and pretty adept to. At a young age in the sport of wrestling, is you're used to the suffering, you learn to embrace it and understand it's just part of the deal, and recognize it's going to be hard. There's no easy way to do it, but the work has to be done, and the quicker you accept that and attack the weight cut just like you would attack anything else, I think it gets a little bit easier. But it's just part of the deal. That's what we got to do.
Shit, man, it's the hardest thing athlete can do, cut weight. Everything outside that's fun. I think when guys cut weight, this is the hardest thing. And I think the happiest thing, a real fighter, the happiest thing inside the cage or inside the octagon. But the weight cut thing is suffering, but I think it built character, it built strength, it built, sometimes it break people and cause people to want to move weight classes and have excuses. But this young man here, this is my fifth fight with him. And every time it get easier and easier, even he's getting older, but it's getting easier because I think mentally he's getting tougher and tougher and tougher. And this is what they call African soldier, you know. They only made him this way in Africa.
It's crazy when we sit back and we look at our life and see how far we've come from Nigeria, you know, getting up and walking 3-4 miles with my mom, you know, so she can sell baby clothes so we can eat that night. And then walk back to the house, and then my mom make us some powdered yam and soup and put it all in one bowl, and me and my brothers would eat out of one bowl. The journey, it really teaches you a lot about your life and teaches you a lot about God, and with him, anything's possible. And for us to be here now fighting on the biggest stage again, just a testament to that. And we're gonna just keep giving him all the glory in taking it one day at a time, and you know, make our family name proud, you know, and it's a blessing.